I'm Will Cook, and I'm here in the maintenance shop here at Holiday World and Splash and Safari amid six Raven roller coaster cars. As you know, we've been working to get the new Timberliners installed on the Voyage, and we've had some issues that we've been struggling with. The delivery was late, and as we've been working through, as with any new product, any new manufactured item, we've been struggling with some things that we've had to make adjustments, make fixes, and change things. And that's not unexpected. We certainly have made the decision that we will not operate the Timberliners until we know they're ready, until they've been tested and they're safe. So, as a result of that, we've had to make some changes in our plans, and we've had to develop a plan B, because our attendance is starting to rise and we need to have more capacity on our Voyage roller coaster. So this Raven car that I'm standing next to is going to become a Voyage car, as is one of the two six-car trains on the Raven is going to become a new red train on the Voyage. And that will happen starting this weekend, and also will continue at least through the next weekend, through Memorial Day weekend. Beyond that, we don't know. The schedule is not fixed, and it depends on the testing schedule of the Timberliners. But this is the plan we're working on right now, is converting these Raven cars to run on the Voyage roller coaster. Let's go take a look at some of the things we're doing to make that happen. We're looking at the back of one of our Raven roller coaster cars. This one's been taken apart, the back seat's been removed, and we're in the process of making a modification to it. Now, the reason for the modification is the Voyage roller coaster, the cars on the Voyage have to articulate more than the cars on the Raven did because of the track design that the Gravity Group did for us. Articulation, very simply, there are two axles in a roller coaster car. There's a front axle, which is basically fixed to the body, and a rear axle, which is free to pivot or articulate relative to the front axle. So on the Voyage, the rear axle on the Raven cars can articulate this far. In order to run on the Voyage, you have to be able to articulate this far. So there's a series of modifications that we do to the cars to make that happen. One is that we add some shim pieces between the chassis of the car and the body. There'll be one here, there'll be another one up here. In addition to that, there's some stops that have to go in this area right here. There's a rubber stop and then two bolts that go in here that are hard stops that will stop put a limit on the articulation on the Voyage car. So that's two of the changes that are happening. And we're going to take a look at the running boards and see the other modification that we're making. Let's go take a look. This is the back part, or this is actually a running board from a Raven car that's already been modified to permit the increased articulation for the Voyage. So the modification consists of adding this piece of wood. You can tell the difference because it doesn't have any grease on it yet. It will soon. Adding this piece of wood and then cutting out a notch in here. And this notch actually permits the road wheels to come up into this space under the running board. And again, the stops in the bottom of the chassis prevent it from articulating to the point where it actually hits the steel plate on top. So this is a modified running board. So those are the three changes that we're making. And our folks are in the process of doing this very rapidly. We anticipate, today is Thursday, we anticipate placing these six Raven cars on the track of the Voyage this evening. We were closed tonight at 3:30 on the Voyage. And we will hopefully run them either tonight or tomorrow morning, and anticipate running two six-car trains, one blue and one red, on the Voyage this weekend on Saturday, and as well any days that we need two trains between now and the next 2 weeks. So that's where we stand, and we're doing the best we can with a little bit of a difficult situation. We thank you for your patience and your understanding as we work through this.